It's hot, hot, hot out there. Summer is finally here. And unlike the last one, this one we can actually go out and enjoy life for the first time in over a year. But if you're anything like me, you perhaps forgot how to get dressed in the morning. But don't worry, we got the best inspiration for you straight from the Fashion Week runway and the best street style in the world to get you ready for your summer days. Welcome to Like I Said, your source for fashion, beauty and Parisian lifestyle on YouTube. No olvides que tenemos subtítulos en español. Et nous avons aussi des sous-titres en français. We are going through one of the hottest summers in history, so we have to dress for the occasion. So let's dive into the first of our top 5 Fashion Week trends for this summer. Remember, you can skip from trend to trend in the description box below. Trend number 1 is crop tops. If you're a millennial like me, you probably remember this one from the last time around in the early 2000s, but this time there's a crucial difference. Back then, we kind of felt we had to be super skinny to wear them, but today, thank God, it's all about embracing your curves and going for it. Crop tops were everywhere in the runway. They are one of the main trends for this summer, and you probably already noticed them on Instagram or on the street. Versace, for example, had a ton. There's a fine line between a crop top and a bra as a top, a trend we already talked about in a previous video that you can check out up here. And yeah, basically a top tends to cover more of the abdomen and a bra has more structure, but you can of course use any. Both are super in right now. And yeah, Versace had it all. At Jacquemus, we saw them mix with another big trend that we won't cover today, but you should keep an eye out for, and that's the strappy everything. Strappy dress, strappy blouse, strappy sandals. As you can see, crop tops can be loose or fitted and worn with skirts, pants, and of course they can have different levels of formality. Fendi proved crop tops can look chic at any age with this look, where a crop top is worn under a sheer top. At Isabel Marant, crop tops were very cropped and festive, and they were mixed with our trend coming up next. Finally, at Chanel, we saw a version for the day, like this cardigan, or this tube top worn with pink jeans, and a couple of versions for the evening with strass or feather embellishment. Now let's check out the street. Gigi Hadid and Selena Gomez wear them with denim. The safest way to do it, in my opinion. Go for a high-rise jean to be more comfortable. And like you saw on the runway, crop tops can be fitted, like this one, or this one shoulder one. Or they can be more loose. You can also play with the sleeve length and go long like Ashley Graham. And finally, here's an example of how you can wear it even as part of a formal look, like the amazing Karin Rothfeld. It's funny because this trend actually came from the street to the runways, so we can thank the likes of Bella Hadid and Kendall Jenner for its popularization. Now for trend number 2. Balloon sleeves. This is a trend that's been growing now for a couple of seasons, and as you can see, I'm wearing it. It's very easy to adopt. On the runways, we saw it on formal silk short sleeve shirts at Lanvin, and like I told you a minute ago, at Isabel Marant, where we found them in dresses, jackets, shirts, of course, an asymmetric jumpsuit, and of course, crop tops. At Patou, we find my personal favorite type of balloon sleeve, and that is the dramatic type. Short or long, they were there in almost every look, and they all had one thing in common: volume. But don't think for a second this trend is exclusive of romantic or girly looks, because Rock, one of the coolest and up-and-coming designers, also had them in their collection. Balloon sleeves were there in tartan, in black, mixed with leather. So you can see they're all over and they can be really cool. And of course, I'm sure you've also noticed this trend on the streets. They can go short or be long, like mine. They can be worn on dresses, which can be contrasted with chunky shoes for a more modern look. They look good in any print and any color. I particularly love this coat because it actually mixes balloon clips with our next trend. Trend number three, it's sheer. Or how to make a layered look in the summer and don't melt trying. Sheer was everywhere, from Acne Studios down to Valentino, where we saw beautiful flowy shirts and dresses. And while this might be a little transparent, I'm sure the boutique version will have a little top underneath or something, don't worry. At Fendi, I think there was a sheer layer in like half of the looks. Sheer dresses and shirts with subtle prints or embroidery were used to add a layer of texture to otherwise more neutral pieces. I personally love the contrast of colors in this look, as this is another huge trend coming up next. Sheer was also present, as we have known it from a few seasons back, in the form of a see-through skirt with a culotte. We saw the trend at Saint Laurent, in printed dresses trimmed with marabou feathers. We also saw sheer fabrics at Dior in a more bohemian style, and they were used to give movement to the gowns. And now let's see how our street style girls wear sheer clothes in real life. You could wear a transparent dress over some covering underwear, or if you're more comfortable showing less skin, you can wear it over a skin-tight jumpsuit. You can also go for just a sheer top, maybe. I love this look because she inverted the thing and actually wore the sheer layer on the inside of her crop top. And finally, a short skirt is always a great way to go to a formal event, but with a bit of a daring edge. The fourth trend we see all over the runways right now is backless everything. At Mugler, of course, ultra sexy backless dresses and bodysuits. But to be fair, in Mugler, we have to admit, there's always a lot of skin showing. At Givenchy, we saw very sexy backless evening dresses. But don't think this trend is only for sexy red carpet gowns, because at Hermès, we saw it in backless bodysuits and dresses, and mixed with monochromatic pieces to create minimalistic and very elegant looks. At Victoria Beckham, we saw it in flowy dresses, and this is how you will find this trend more often in real life. At Nina Ricci, bags were showing from dresses and jackets. This trend, I think, is easy to wear because it's a sort of understated sexiness, like in these dresses, for example. And as you can see, the backless and the balloon sleeves, they actually go really well together. My advice would be, don't feel self-conscious about showing your back and enjoy the extra ventilation during the summer months. Our final trend for the day is actually a carry-on trend from the winter, but you can still wear it during the summer, and that's trend number five. Color blocking, summer edition. We kept seeing this all over the runways, and you can keep wearing it too. At Givenchy, we saw strong color mixed together. I think at Versace is where we saw it the most, actually, or at least where we saw the brightest colors being used. I love that combination of bright green with everything else. The vibrant colors are even both present on the same garment in some cases, or they also played with a bright bag for contrast with the rest of the look. At Bottega Veneta, we found color blocking in thick knit looks. And at Nina Ricci, very bright hues, especially in the accessories, and they were mixed with more neutral tones in the clothes. Or we also find a contrast of bright and neutral in the same garment. I actually love this combination of yellow and cream. I think it's very chic. The British designer Roxanda is known for her color blocking, and of course this collection was no exception. And for real life, you can imagine that this trend is very easy to adopt, so let's go check out our street style. Honestly, it suffices to find a piece that mixes two strong colors together, or you can do the mix yourself, like Beyoncé. The color combinations are endless, and they can allow you to wear those pieces in the back of your closet you thought maybe didn't go with anything else. And don't worry, you can even color block in the heat. You just need to add a pop of color in one of your garments or accessories. And you can do it in the evening too, like Miranda Kerr, who's not only wearing this trend, but also wearing a crop top. Final note on this trend, The color you mix can also be pastels if you don't really like a bright palette. And that's it for this year's hottest trends for the summer, my friends. Now go out there and make up for all the fun we missed last year. Just before you go, don't forget to give us a little thumbs up if you like this video and subscribe to Lagazette for more fashion and hit that notifications button to be among the first people to watch our next video. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time. That's a siren. I'm in Paris. I'm filming in Paris. There are sirens all the time. And still there. That's the music of the city.